What if someday your blood test report shows that your blood contains plastic in it? Seems very scary, right? But research has proved this. So what exactly is the case? Let's find out. Plastic has become an integral part of our life. It is found everywhere. Plastic is found in water bodies, in soil, in our food, in our blood. Hey, wait, what? In our blood? Yes, you heard it right. So is this a threat to human life? Will human life end? To get the answer to these questions, stay tuned till the end. Also, it's a guarantee that you will learn a lot of new things in this video. So let's begin. A research funded by Dutch National Organization for Health Research and Development and Common Seas examined blood samples from 22 anonymous healthy volunteers and found microplastics in nearly 80% of them. But what exactly was found in them and in what quantities? Let's find out. Half of these blood samples contained PET plastic. This material is used to manufacture plastic bottles. Also, other samples contain polystyrene, which is used for packaging food and other products, and polyethylene, which is used to manufacture plastic carry bags. Though the quantity of plastic was very less, that is 1.6 microgram of plastic per milliliter of blood, but this is enough to raise concerns about human health conditions. But the question is, how do these plastic particles enter the human body? Through which medium do these harmful plastics enter a human bloodstream? Studies found that these particles enter the human body through food. For example, if you consume fish, then a lot of plastic is present in seas and oceans, so the water life also gets affected by these plastic particles, and ultimately humans get affected if they consume fish. Also, if you consume food in plastic containers, especially hot food, harmful chemicals from which plastic is made can enter your body. Plastic particles can also enter human body through water that we consume. Now, the plastic we are talking about is microplastic. So what are they? Plastics in the ocean breaks into very small particles. These small plastic bits are known as microplastics. So what did scientists conclude? The results of the research support a hypothesis that human exposure to plastic particles can result in the absorption of these particles into the bloodstream. Which means scientists just believed that plastic particles can enter the bloodstream, but this research proved it. Also, researchers found that these particles can cause chronic inflammation, which means a human body will continue sending inflammatory cells even when there is no outside danger. According to scientists, these particles can cause a damage to human cells. Also, according to a research paper, microplastics can deform cell membranes and affect their functioning. Cell membrane, also known as plasma membrane, regulates the transport of materials entering and exiting the cell. Scary facts, right? But wait, there is something scarier than this. According to research, microplastics can latch on to the outer membranes of red blood cells, and this may limit their ability to transport oxygen. Also, these particles were found in placentas of pregnant women. A baby inside a mother's womb receives its food and water through placenta, and the presence of plastic in placenta is not good for the baby as well as the mother. Also, one of the scariest facts is that these microplastics available in water cannot be removed completely even by filtering it. So what then shall we do? The only possible remedy to mitigate this risk can be avoiding plastic containers to store food and water, and avoiding single-use plastics. So if you love our content and you gain knowledge from it, then press on the like button and do share this video with your friends so that they could also gain this valuable knowledge. Thanks for watching. See you in the next one.